sending traffic to your Amazon product listing using Google advertising. And very recently, Amazon changed something in their product listings. Before, if you send Google traffic, you would see competitors' advertising at the top, but now Amazon removed it, and it happened with the help of AMPD, EMPT company, and one of the representatives is here today in this video, Brandon Nutter. And this video I'm hosting together with Lisette. Hello, Lisette.
Hi, Augustus. Great to be back here with you and also with Brandon from EMPT. So I'm excited to invite you here with us as well. So Brandon, how are you doing? And before we start with everything, could you first introduce yourself and also explain a little bit more how EMPT helps Amazon sellers?
Yeah, thanks for having me. My name is Brandon Nutter, CTO and co-founder here at EMPT. And EMPT is pretty simple. We help you drive high quality traffic from Google Ads to your Amazon store. And we see Google as really high quality, high converting traffic. So we believe it's a pretty big deal.
And what would you say is driving external traffic to Amazon or driving external traffic from Google something that we hear more and more about? And what's the reason behind it?
Yeah, you know, a lot of these Amazon sellers now are looking for multiple ways to bring new customers in. So what brands are finding is that Amazon ads is always one of the best ways in order to grab new customers and high converting traffic. But as these brands are building their brand, their moat, they're looking at how to bring new customers from email, how to bring it from influencers, and how to bring it from other channels such as Google and Google Ads. And so really what it is, it's brand building for these Amazon sellers to really build a multi-channel marketing funnel that will make them successful in the long run.
All right. So in this session, we will have a few slides, right? Preparing his slides. I wanted to mention that if you're watching a recording, don't forget to ask questions below in the comment section so that Brandon can answer your questions later. And yeah, if you like this video at some point, don't forget to hit like and subscribe. And I see we have already slides. We see them. So Brandon, please present what's happening in your cooperation with Amazon.
We're excited to be a partner on Amazon Attribution team. And really what that means is that we're on the cutting edge of really figuring out what's working and what's not working in terms of Google Ads going to Amazon. And today I'm excited to share in combination with the Orange Click team on some really exciting updates that Amazon's done just recently. And so before we get into this important update, just wanted to set the stage for why Google is important, especially for sellers where they're trying to really build a brand and have a multi-channel approach. So that way you're bringing customers in from email, from influencers, and from Google. And so what we see here, and this is a screenshot from SEMrush, is that direct is obviously one of the biggest ways that Amazon people come to Amazon to shop. But the second way that people find Amazon and shop on Amazon is they come in from Google. And so what this means is that there's about a billion customers that come in, a billion searches that come in from Google monthly that go into Amazon.com. So what does this mean for a seller? This means that in order to be competitive now, you need to be at the top of Google. And not only do you need to be at the top of Google, you need to be at the top of Google for the right searches. And so, and what you'll notice down here is that a lot of these searches, like you'll see DuckDuckGo and Yahoo, but these are high intent searches where customers are searching for products on Google, on these other search engines, and are going directly to your Amazon.com site, a category site, but ultimately a product listing site or a storefront page. So let's look at what this looks like. So if you're selling a French press on Amazon, then your customers are going to be searching for French press Amazon. And what you'll notice is that there's not a lot of competition on Google. And what's great about this is that building a brand, this means that you're able to get in front of your customers very quickly when they're searching for your products. And not only are you able to get in front of them, but you're able to talk about your product. You're able to talk about your brand, what makes you unique, and talk about your ratings and why you're Amazon Prime and all the things that make you unique as a brand. So here's the best part. When you search for a product, what will happen is if you do Google Ads, you will show up at the top of the page. And once you show up at the top of the page, when a customer clicks, they go directly to your category page or your product page. And especially if it's your product page, what you're doing is you're transporting the customer directly what they're looking for, what they're searching for, to that product that you're selling, and then they're able to add it right then. And what we've seen is, especially on a mobile device, this works really well. If you have a lot of social proof, if you have a lot of reviews, a lot of ratings, then all of a sudden, when someone comes to your site, it's very easy for them to click the buy button. So just a few more things on why this is important strategically for your brand is this allows you to get above the competition. So if you're just doing Amazon ads, for instance, then you might have 5, 6, maybe 10 other competitors that are doing Amazon ads. But if you're advertising on Google, you may only have 1 or 2 other competitors. So this is a way to get ahead of the competition. The second thing that I'm really excited about is Amazon released this thing. It's called the BRB. It stands for the Brand Referral Bonus. So anytime you bring your own customers from Google going to your Amazon product listings or category or page, what will happen is they will give you 10% back on every sale. Now, I know that it adds up when you sell on Amazon, but this is a really great thing that Amazon's doing to incentivize you to bring your own customers in. And really what they're trying to do is they're trying to subsidize the ad spend that you're sending. They're saying, hey, look, you're bringing your customers in. We want to give you 10% back in order to help with that ad cost. And the last one that we see all across the board is just increase organic sales. And Amazon was saying this in another case study from a previous webinar, but it's really important when you have a multi-channel approach, it starts that flywheel for Amazon. And what that really means is that Amazon now takes note. They say, oh, you're getting clicks and high conversions on Amazon ads. You're also bringing your offsite or external traffic on from Google, and that's converting as well. And all of a sudden, you will see organic rank increase, and that directly results into an increase in organic sales. So these are all good things to keep in mind when you're building a brand and when you're creating your moat and when you're really thinking holistically on how to bring customers from every channel. So let's talk about conversion rate. So when we talk about a conversion rate, what we'll often see is that desktop conversion rate will be a bit higher than mobile conversion rate. And this is still because when a customer comes in from Google and going to your product listing page, if they're at their desktop, it's just very easy for them to convert right then. And perhaps on mobile, what they're doing is they're still in the shopping phase. They haven't quite bought yet. You'll notice that both of them are pretty similar, but still desktop is a bit higher. Well, what happened is early this year, what we noticed is that mobile conversion rate was higher than desktop conversion rate. And this was something that our engineering and our data science team and product team noticed very quickly. And as we started looking across the board, what we noticed is that mobile conversion rate, even if you had a lot of reviews, if you were the lowest price, was still higher than desktop. And what we found is that that's usually not the case across the board with Google Ads, especially in a D2C or direct-to-consumer product or page. That's usually not the case. So my team and I, we looked at that early this year, and here's what we found. We found that when people were sending Google Ads traffic over to their product pages, that there was these competitors at the top of the page. And when you have competitors at the top of the page, what this means is that for your customer, you could potentially lose that click. You could potentially lose that customer. And especially if they have higher reviews and a lower price. Well, we also noticed something else that was significant. We noticed that the brands that had the most reviews and the ratings and the lowest price would usually win. They had a high conversion rate, and that they would have a high conversion rate on desktop and they would have a high conversion rate on mobile. Now, in this particular case, as we look at this product, notice that there's three other competitive products up here, but also notice that they have a lot more reviews than anyone else. So they have more social proof and their price is relatively the same. So as a customer looks at this, if the image is right, if the product description, the social proof, and also the price is low, they'll add here. But what happens though, if you don't have the lowest price, if you don't have the social reviews, what we were seeing through the data is that you could potentially lose the click. And losing the click means that a customer would click on your competitor at the top of the page. So here's an example. This is an example where basically a brand didn't have as many ratings as its competition, and it didn't have the lowest price. So if we compare this, we look at this particular product in comparison to another product, they may not have the lowest price. And so what we figured out here is that if you looked on mobile, then mobile wouldn't have the competitive ads here at the top of the page. And so for this particular example, what we found is that that's the reason why mobile conversion rate was a lot higher than the desktop conversion rate, was because for all products that didn't have the best rating, that didn't have essentially the lowest price, they would lose their click. But on mobile, they wouldn't, because you wouldn't see those competitive ads. So here's the really neat thing. We talked with our Amazon attribution partners, and we gave them the data for what we were seeing. And they agreed. They agreed to change this for the customers, for Amazon customers, so that way you're not just showing your product on here and your competitors. And so, for instance, you'll see there's competitor products here. This is what it was before, three competitors at the top of the page. But now you're only showing your brand products. So the reason why this is so valuable is now when you bring Google Ads traffic to your product pages, Amazon's prioritizing your brand. So that way only your products show up at the top. So before, competitors showed up, now only your products. So in terms of building a brand and building a moat, you're now able to really build a moat around your brand to make sure that you're protecting it, and to make sure that only your products at the top or variations of your product are showing up. And what we're finding now is now conversion rates are really increasing now, and not just for mobile, but for desktop as well. And so it used to be that you would send a combination of traffic to a product page and also to a storefront page. And through this, what would happen is that you would have a winning strategy, because a storefront page, you wouldn't have competition. It's just your page. But now that you have only your product brands at the top, now you're able to really understand that Amazon's putting their best foot forward and they're making sure that only your products show up. And it kind of makes sense too, right? If you're paying for your traffic that through Google Ads and you're going to your product pages, you definitely want to make sure that only your products are showing up. So what does this mean in terms of being a successful Amazon seller? This really means that Google Ads is one of the best ways to get ahead of your competition. and really grab the customer as they're searching for your products. If you think about the customer journey as they're searching and in the buyer journey of looking for products similar to what you're selling, then Google Ads is the second place where they start their journey. And we saw that at the beginning of the slide deck, where 10% of the traffic that's coming into Amazon.com is coming from Google. So what's really neat here now is that now you can see the customer as they're searching, and keywords that are working in Amazon, you can now take similar keywords, not exact keywords, but similar keywords that represent your product, such as French press Amazon, and grab them while they're doing the Google search. And now when they finally click on your ad on Google Ads at the top of Google, they will go to your product page. And once they're at your product page, they will not see your competitors at the top. So we see this as a great way to get ahead of the competition in building your moat and being really a multi-channel approach in building your brand, especially when you're at the side of scaling. So what's really neat is we've seen this across our customers as well. Customers are saying that this is really a big deal. And we see agencies, aggregators, large brands all talking about that they're now increasing their Google spend in order to grab the customers, especially since there's no competitors at the top. They see this as a competitive advantage to get ahead of the competition. So just taking through what we've developed at Amped, and to make this easy, is the idea around Amped is we just want to make this super easy to get started with Google Ads. So we can create your Google Ads account. We can get you connected if you have an existing Google Ads account. We even offer a $500 coupon provided through our partner Google to get started. And really what this means is that there's only a few steps to connect Google to Amazon and be successful in creating your first product. And what's neat now is we even do a live onboarding with customers. So we schedule a time just so that we can explain the process and really get you going to be successful. And so just going through step by step, the first way that you get started with Amped is you connect your Google and Amazon accounts. And then what you do to finish the example on with the French press is that you put in your ASIN, and the AMP technology automatically understands your ASIN, your products from Amazon. And then what we do is we connect your Amazon attribution account automatically. This is the really neat thing, where now you don't have to use Amazon attribution tags and do the manual set. You can instantly do that through AMP. And what this does is that anytime a customer clicks your Google ad, we will automatically tag it. It's automated attribution. Therefore, you won't have to manually go and create tags in Amazon attribution. We take care of all that for you. And the nice part is that we show you an ROI and help you optimize that ad. So the idea is that we're trying to take time away, so that way give your time back to you to focus on the most important parts of your business. But then we take care of the data, the plumbing, and the optimizations that go into sending high quality traffic from Google Ads over to Amazon. And then finally, what we do is we track organic search terms. So as we put in these search terms, since rank does go up organically, we want to make sure that we can track these organic search terms and give you a way to understand not only your ACoS and ROI across your account, but so you can really understand, what is my organic lift across these search terms that I'm using to send Google traffic over to Amazon? And once again, we're pretty proud of the engineering and the technology and the product that we put together. What we've done is we have a firsthand integration with Google Ads. So that means that we can find really good, high quality keywords. We can show the cost per click, how many searches. And what you'll notice here, which is really neat, is there's a lot of searches that are happening on Google. And so what we've done is put this into our platform so that when you're picking keywords for your product, you can quickly understand what the search volume will be, what the conversion rate will be, what the low bid or the high bid will be. And what's really neat too is that if you're picking really good keywords, and especially as you can kind of see the cost per click, then with our technology, you can put in a max cost per click, and you can also pick keywords that have a relatively low cost per click and high search volume. So this will allow you to get keywords that are at 30 cents, 40 cents, 50 cents, 70 cents, and things that are very cheap where other people are overlooking these and overlooking the Google Ads channel, but you are doubling and tripling down on these keywords. So at the end, we allow you to make your ad. So essentially within 10 minutes, you're able to connect your Google Ads to Amazon. You're finding great keywords, tracking the organic search terms, and finally creating and crafting a good ad. And our technology is designed such that you can make a good ad with our software. And the other thing with our expertise and in-amped experts is that we help you create your ad as well. So on onboarding, we can help you create an ad with best practices and get you going. So that way you're very successful in trying this new channel. So then you pick your budget and you're ready to go. And notice you can put your max cost per click in here too. So that way we safeguard it to make sure you're not paying more than $2. So the exciting part is that since Amazon's giving that 10% back on the bonus, then what that means then is that if you're getting significant sales through Google Ads going to Amazon, and keep in mind, you have to enroll for the brand referral bonus and you have to tag it. So AMP, since it's a verified partner with Amazon Ads and the Amazon attribution team, we automatically tag things for you. So you're enabled for that brand referral bonus. But the brand referral bonus really adds up. So we have customers where, even small customers, where they're starting with the brand referral bonus, they're starting their journey. And then we have larger customers where they're getting a significant amount of money back from the brand referral bonus. So once again, it's a very exciting time to drive external traffic over to your Amazon store. And AMP is one of the fastest and best ways in order to do that, to be successful and get a great ROI. All right, yeah, let's stop there. And if there's any questions, I can answer any questions.
All right, thank you so much, Brandon, for giving the introduction to using Google Ads for Amazon products and also explaining the change. And I think the Amazon sellers community is really thankful for you working together so closely with the Amazon team to make the change. So how easy it was actually to talk and explain the issue to them and kind of get them to experiment this new layout.
You know, that was the amazing part about the Amazon attribution team is Eric and Andrew from the Amazon attribution team did such a wonderful job understanding the problem and really working with AMP from the attribution team to really figure out how is this going to impact customers. And this change was less than 6 months. They were able to understand the change with our data set. They were able to get that in front of product managers. And then within 6 months, they were able to make that technical change to the to their Amazon category and catalog. And I think that really says a lot for a really big company such as Amazon, where they can move very quickly and they're listening to their customers and they're listening to their partners. And ultimately what they're doing is they want to provide a better product. They want to provide a better service. And so it gives me a lot of confidence and a lot of momentum to keep developing and really trying to be the best that we can for the Amazon team and ultimately our Amazon sellers. So it was hats off to them. It was really fantastic how fast and how quick they moved with the whole change.
Amazing. And we have a few follow-up questions. Before that, I wanted to mention to everyone, if you're enjoying this news, if you are really appreciating AMP's work, don't forget to click like and subscribe. And also, if you want to try AMP's platform, you will find the link below in the description and you can join them. And if you have questions, as he said, as Brandon said, there are now onboarding calls, which is a great service. And by the way, Brandon, you can, if you want, you can shut down your slides. I see still. Probably you don't see us. Now you see us, right? Perfect.
Thank you.
So let me ask you a question related to this update. So is this available this update to all marketplaces only in Amazon US?
Yeah, it is available to all marketplaces. And what I'd like to put an asterisk is that this change is still in beta. And what's really important about this change is that Amazon, they've made this change, they're testing it. But the more that they hear from Amazon sellers on how important this change is, and you can post in the comments of this video and check out our site and just make sure to look at the link on this YouTube video. The more they hear about how amazing this change is from sellers like you, that's where it really makes a difference. So it is available right now on Amazon.com. It is being launched into different marketplaces, but as Amazon releases things, they release it in beta and then they finally release it in full general availability. But we'll have a higher confidence level that this is going to reach general availability as you're reaching out to your Amazon representatives and Amazon ads partners to talk about this change.
Okay, so yeah, everybody has to be loud about it and use it a lot.
Yes.
So as you mentioned during your presentation, when driving Google Ads traffic to Amazon, there are two ways. So I wanted to ask what usually brings better results, if you can say so based on your data, driving traffic straight to the product listing page or doing that and driving traffic to the storefront?
Yeah, you know, it used to be that the storefront page was better converting than an individual product page. And that was simply because the competitor widgets were at the top. So you would see the competition. So if you didn't have the lowest price, if you didn't have the highest reviews, then you would want to go to a branded storefront page that you own. So that way there's no competitors at the top. And so, but now that the product listing page doesn't have the competitors at the top, it only has your ASINs and your products and your variants. Now it's a very valid approach to do either storefront or a product listing page. And the other thing I would help remind the audience as well is that it's extremely important to be able to, if you have variations. So for instance, let's say you have different versions of your French press and you mark a keyword such as French press, where it's basically just different variations, but it's a more broad keyword, then you do want to have a storefront page where you can show all your variations of the French press. And that's going to help convert customers, because if they don't like a particular variation, but they like another variation, you want to give your customers the best chance to really click and convert. So storefront pages are still extremely valuable, and it's a great strategy. And usually what AMP will do as a platform and as a service is we'll help set up storefronts, we'll help set up individual product pages and really give you kind of the expert level best strategies to win on Google.
All right, we have a question from Noemi. Noemi, are the bids very high on Google Ad?
Yeah, this is, it's all relative. So it's relative to your category and it's relative to how well you pick your keywords. What we do in AMP'd, so you can do this outside of AMP'd or in AMP'd. If you're doing this outside of AMP'd, what you'll do is you'll look at Keyword Planner. Keyword Planner is available in Google Ads and it allows you to see a min CPC and a max CPC for keywords that you're looking for. So as you're looking for these keywords, the idea is looking for high intent keywords that have the chance for your customers to purchase, but that are lower cost per click. So there's always going to be higher cost per click keywords. Ignore those for the right now. Pick those lower cost per keywords. So your cost is going to stay controlled just as long as you're picking good keywords and that you're putting a max cost per click on there. So we usually recommend $1.50 or up to $2 for max cost per click. So that way you're not spending $3 or $4 on a cost per click, because you shouldn't have to do that.
So it's a good point you mentioned, like people can use your service or run Google Ads directly. So my question would be, what's the difference between running Google Ads with the Google advertising platform and interface and using AMP'd? You already mentioned you can use Google Keyword Planner.
Right.
Does AMP'd have also possibilities to kind of find the keywords? Or
we do. So we actually integrated. So since we're a first party partner with Google, what we did is we built Keyword Planner within AMP. So you can use Keyword Planner within AMP. You get the same functionality that you would get with Google itself. Really, the difference happens is that if you're going to set up Google Ads yourself in Attribution, what's really hard to do is get keyword level ACoS or ROI. And what happens is when you look at your keywords in your ad copy, you have to be sure as an advertiser that your cost per clicks are low in those keywords and the keywords that you picked are getting conversions. And so with our technology, in less than 10 minutes, you can set up all that and AMP does that automatically. If you're going to use Google Ads with Amazon Attribution and you don't have our technology, then there's a lot of manual setup in order to get right. And so the idea is that we're professionals, we're experts, we've developed technology, we're venture backed. So we wanted to create technology to make this easy for Amazon sellers. So that way you could focus on the things that are the highest value to your company.
Sounds really good. So question regarding setting up a first campaign. So what kind of campaign structure should sellers use when they first set up their first ads?
Yeah, great question. So if you're going to Google Ads without AMP, what you'll want to do is you'll go to ads.google.com, create your first ad, and the ads that we use are responsive search ads. So we found that responsive search ads have the best conversion rate. And what's really interesting about this is that the things that you want to do in your advertisements is that you want to include, if you have a lot of ratings, a lot of reviews, you want to include that in there. And you also want to include keywords in your ad copy. The same keywords that you're matching customers on, you want to put that in your ad copy and in your responsive search ad. I haven't looked at Performance Max campaigns in high detail. I know that Google's still testing those out, but we're excited to start looking at that as well. But for right now, I would stick with just regular search ads, responsive search ads, and those should be high performing, just as long as you're picking good keywords and really putting the effort and the time in to make sure it works.
Okay, so question about keywords then. So should sellers start advertising by first targeting their best performing Amazon PPC keywords, or what's the best way to choose the first ones?
Just repeating that question a little bit, what are the best keywords to start with when you're starting?
Yeah, basically. So is it usually common, for example, that Amazon start by using the keywords they already use in Amazon PPC, for example, and which already perform well for them?
Yeah, definitely. So what we usually find is that there's not a direct translation to keywords on Google. So if you copy and paste your keywords from Amazon into Google, it won't work out of the box. So the what you have to do is, we've developed technology at AMP to where we help find the keywords that translate into Google land from Amazon land and help you with that process. If you're doing it outside of AMP, then what you want to do is you'll take each one of your keywords in that's converting really well on Amazon, put it into Keyword Planner, and then find the correlative keywords in Google to add to Google. And so, for instance, let me just give you one example. And this one's kind of an easy example. But a customer is not going to search for the keyword French press Amazon on Amazon because they're already in Amazon, right? So what they'll do is, if you search for French press on Google, then one of the keywords that could come up is French press Amazon. So that's going to be a different keyword combination that you don't have in your current Amazon ads, but that will be a keyword that you'll want to put into your Google keyword list. And the other thing to really think through is that on your keyword list is, you'll want to really use tight keywords. And what I mean by tight is on the matching type. So we use usually exact, which are the brackets, or we do phrase match, which are the quotes. So as you get started, it's really easy to kind of get out of control, and that's the broad match. So you'll want to just make sure that you stick with a tighter match to get started, and then really look at your keywords every week. And that's a service that AMP offers as well. We help our customers look for new keywords that are converting and really make sure that with our data science technology that you're finding the best keywords all the time.
Great. Thank you very much for your answers. Do Google advertising campaigns need some time to settle to actually start working and before sellers should make any conclusions about the results? So what's the time to make results?
Yeah, 100%. So usually we see that you should see conversions in the first month. And you need a budget to do this with. So if you're just doing $100 a month, that's not going to be a fair test. Mm-hmm. And so the budget that we do for a campaign, and a campaign matches to a product or to a product landing page, is usually $15 a day. And so the idea is that try three or four of your products. And those three or four products each are $15 a day. And this is the nice part too. Google actually gives you $500 ad credits. That's like $500 of free customers coming to your Amazon store. So run those three or four campaigns for three or four of your products. And the idea is to run them for a few months. And over a few months, what you should see is you should see the ROI level out. And during that 3 or 4 months, what's really important is it's not set and forget. You really do need to look at your keywords, and keywords that are not performing well, you want to take those out of the auction. Keywords that are performing well, you want to keep those. Luckily, AMPT has provided a lot of data science to make sure to take out keywords out of your campaigns, out of the auction, that are not performing well. Ones that are doing well, our team helps you look for similar types of keywords on our AMPT Pro package. But yeah, so to summarize this, you need at least 3 or 4 campaigns, $15 a day at minimum, and you want to run this for a few months. And this is for if you're looking to scale new customers, getting to your brand and really providing that moat.
All right. So let's say someone has a product, and what would be your suggestion to calculate the budget? Like just to take minimum $15 a day, or I don't know, it depends on maybe the price of the product because there is less conversions if it's more expensive.
Yeah, you know, 15, the way that we think about it at AMPT is that $15 a day, if you're getting a dollar a click, then that's 15 visitors that you have coming in a day. And if you start looking at conversion rates, you know, Google is not going to have as good of conversion rates as Amazon ads. Amazon ads will always have a better conversion rate from what we've seen. But the conversion rate, you could have 3 or 4% conversion rate. So you just want to make sure that you give it enough traffic, enough visitors to really understand which keywords work. It's the way we look at it is that it's really the name of the game is figure out which keywords do really well. As soon as you figure out that common set of keywords in the next few months that do extremely well, then what you do is you start ramping up your budget. So start with $15 a day. You know, start with 10 to 15 keywords. You'll probably end up with 3 or 4 keywords in your campaign that are doing really well. From those 3 or 4 keywords, then you get into an ACoS that is reasonable for your company as you look at the total ACoS in combination. And then you start increasing your budget to scale to bring those new customers in.
Okay, thank you for that. So you mentioned the conversion rates a little bit. So should sellers worry about the fact that Google Ads might first have lower conversions and therefore there might be a negative effect to the existing product page ranking?
No, you know, since we've been partnered with the Amazon Attribution team and the Amazon Ads team, they have several case studies. And one of our case studies is on the Amazon Ads page as well. And what it talks about is the increase in organic traffic. And when I talk about these conversion rates, if you think about it from Amazon's perspective, if you're bringing your own customers into your Amazon store, Amazon looks at external traffic differently than internal traffic. Internal traffic being from Amazon ads or organic. And so what that means then is Amazon's highly incentivized for you to bring in new customers, which is why they're giving you the 10% back. So if thinking about this logically and in the way that the Amazon team has helped us think about it, if Amazon is punishing you with conversion rates for bringing new traffic in to your product pages or your store listing pages, then really what happens is Amazon's losing out and not incentivizing you to bring your own traffic in. And it's exactly the opposite. Amazon is incentivizing you with the 10% brand referral bonus, in showing you that organic rankings increasing and therefore organic sales increasing. So really all that's happening is that it's another channel, and Amazon looks at external traffic and weighs external traffic differently than internal traffic. That's a great question.
Thank you for that. So are you aware of what kind of data Amazon shares with sellers inside of Seller Central and on Amazon Attribution Dashboard?
Yeah, so the Amazon Attribution is a great product. So we've worked with the Amazon Attribution team. We've been watching them build that out. And the Amazon Attribution is great because it shows you the brand referral bonus. So you'll see the brand referral bonus, how much money you're getting back. You'll see clicks that are happening. You'll also see sales and conversions. And the way that they've set it up is they've set it up at a campaign level. So let's say you're running four products and each of those have a campaign. You will see four different campaigns in Amazon Attribution. Now, what you won't see though, is you won't see the keyword level. So that's where Amazon Ads API partner and attribution partner such as Amped, we're able to give you the keyword level ROI and the keyword level conversion. And the reason why that's so important is because you need to be able to basically update your campaigns at a keyword level. If a keyword is not converting, you need to pause it. If a keyword is converting, you need to find more keywords like that. And so that's the hard part to do with Amazon Attribution, is get to that keyword level ACoS and that keyword level ROI. But from looking at your brand referral bonus, looking at your conversions from a top level perspective, the Amazon Attribution UI is great.
Great. And everyone else, if you enjoy this talk and if you enjoy this news about Google advertising and traffic from Google to Amazon product listing, hit like and click subscribe, and also check Amped's website. Also, you'll find below in the description if you want to sign up with their software and see if you could run Google advertising campaigns using their algorithms and easy to use dashboard. And we have one more question about related topic. So what to do differently if people add products to the cart, but conversions are still low? Do you have any advice?
Interesting. So we often see this if the add to carts are high, but the conversions are low, that people are in are price shopping. And that's a good indicator there. Now, the interesting thing too is that the Amazon Attribution is a 14-day attribution window. So it could be that people are keeping the products in the cart for longer than 14 days or longer than just a few days. So two good things I would suggest. The first one is that if there's a lot of add to carts, I would give it the full 14 days when you're looking at either Amped or the Amazon Attribution UI to see what the actual conversions are. And if you have a suspicion that it's past the 14 days where people are converting with those add to carts, then I would look at your top line sales. And we often do this as well with customers where we'll look at top line sales to see if there's a sales increase across their whole platform based on particular products. The other idea too is that one more idea to throw at in this is that if it's a particular product and it's a very specific product and you have variations of that product, it might be interesting to try a storefront page where you have multiple variations of your product, because maybe they're looking for a different color, maybe they're looking for a different size or a different variation. And that's where you could grab that customer so you don't lose them to a competitor.
Okay, very good. Thank you for that. So regarding keywords, would you recommend choosing long tail keywords or rather broader and shorter keywords for the first campaigns?
Yeah, great question. So the winning strategy is long tail keywords, but not too long tail. And what I mean by that is when you look at search volume, and we'll show you search volume in our keyword forecaster, which is built from Google. So you can go to Google and see that as well in the Google Keyword Planner. And you need to look for keywords that have a volume, you know, it has to be north of 100. So what that number is when it says search volume, it's how many people are searching and typing that keyword in monthly. So if it's only 100 people and you're only getting a 10% click-through rate, then you're only going to get 10 people, you know, come in a month. So you really do want to start looking for 250, 500, 1,000 search volume monthly. But the name of the game is you still want to look for long tail keywords. So let me give an example. If you're looking for French press, that is a broader keyword. It's going to have more search volume. But if you're looking for French press glass or French press chrome, all of a sudden that is going to be a tighter and more long tail keyword. But my guess is that it's still going to have significant search volume, over 1,000 searches a month. And it's going to have, you know, a relatively good cost per click. So the name of the game is finding enough search volume and looking at the cost per click to make sure that the cost per click is not going to be $2 or $3 to get on the top of the page, but is closer to the kind of that $1.50 or that dollar range. And then you're always constantly adding keywords. So if you only add keywords once, then and you visit it in a month or 2 months, it's not probably going to be good. So you want to go back in weekly, look at which keywords are getting conversions, and the ones that are getting conversions, keep those. But if you're not getting clicks, go back in, add more keywords, and keep adding those long tail keywords.
Thank you very much. We really appreciate the long and detailed answers because these really help sellers to run their ads a little bit better. So to wrap up, one more question. I think many sellers are often wondering, so is it a good idea to start running Google ads during a product launch phase?
I this is a mixed answer for me. And so the reason why it's a mixed answer is because you want to have your expectations set correctly. So if you're doing a brand new product launch and you have very little reviews and you're just getting this product to market, then Google can be a great way to get customers that are ready to buy in your product. What we find though is that for those product launches, if you're looking at ACOS or ROI for that, that's not the right metric to look at. The right metric to look at is how many new customers do I have at that product page? And how is my rank going up for my organic listings? And because the whole game is you want to make sure to get more qualified traffic to that page that is going to convert and people that are going to leave reviews. And then once you start getting north of 100 reviews for your products, then now you can start looking at ROI and you can start looking at ACOS. So it's really just expectation setting. I think it's a great way to bring traffic in. But what I don't want to promise is that you can push Google Ads traffic to your new products and have an amazing ROI, because that may not be the case.
Okay, thank you very much for that.
All right, so thank you very much, Brandon, for all these insights about the update. And thank you for fighting with Amazon to get better results for Amazon sellers. And once again, I want to remind that if you want to try AMPT and run your Google Ads using intelligent dashboard, check the link below for AMPT software. And if you have any questions, just reach out to their support team. Brandon, thanks a lot. What else are you working on with Amazon? Can you reveal, or we will just make another video in 3 months about good news?
Yeah, you know, I think what's neat is that the Amazon attribution team is, in conjunction with AMPT, is really focused on how to provide even more metrics and more value to the customers. So the thing that was just launched just recently was the brand referral bonus that was available to API partners and available in the UI. So what's neat about that is now you can finally see how much money Amazon's giving you back. So not giving anything away here, but I think in the future, what you'll see is that as Amazon attribution is releasing more products, as it's becoming more mainstream here, you're going to see more value in the Amazon attribution UI. You're going to see more value in AMPT. And you're going to see right now, when I feel like when I talk about Google Ads going to Amazon, it's still a very new thing. in the next year, it's probably going to be a pretty mainstream thing. So, and the Amazon attribution team is excited about that as well, because Google is such a significant amount of traffic going to Amazon. So yes, we'll see some new updates here very soon, and looking forward to connecting with you guys and releasing that here first on the
Perfect. Perfect. And if you still, if somebody is still watching and wants to ask additional questions about this update or anything else about Google Ads, you are welcome to type in your questions below in the description. So it will give us also ideas what additional videos probably we could create with AMPT and answer your questions. So thank you very much, Brandon. Thank you, Lisette.
Thank you. See you.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Bye-bye. And now I would like to invite you to watch other video with Brandon, where he explains how to set up, create, and run Google Ads for Amazon FBA products.